Hello friends, welcome to Practical Ninjas. Subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon if not done already to be a part of our notification squad. In the last video, we understood the concept and working of an atomic absorption spectroscopy. If you haven't checked the video, you can find the links in the description. In this video, let us try to understand the theory of atomic emission spectroscopy. This phenomena works by exciting an atom to a higher energy level and studying the energy emitted by that atom when it falls back to its initial energy level. So basically, we are interested in the emissions given out by the atoms. By studying the emissions, the user can identify the type of atoms as well as its quantity. This means that the user can perform both the qualitative and quantitative analysis on the sample. Let us proceed by understanding the construction of this instrument. The first component is the sample holder. As seen here, this instrument is made up of atomizer with flow controls for oxygen and fuel. The atomizer converts the sample to aerosol and passes this aerosolized sample to the next unit. The next component is the flame. The flame is employed to heat the aerosolized sample and provide energy to the atoms present in the sample. The atoms take up this energy and go to higher atomic state. The flame is followed by a monochromator, which filters out the wavelengths, and the final part of the instrument is the detector and display. Now, let us understand the working of this unit. As stated earlier, the sample is first converted into aerosol form. Then, this aerosol is made to pass into the flame. The aerosol contains the atoms from the sample. Once in the flame, these atoms absorb energy. The energy differences between the atomic states is different for different atoms. As a result, different atoms will absorb different amounts of energy as required by them. These atoms cannot remain in the higher energy state for too long. As a result, they fall back to their original atomic state by releasing energy. The energy is released in the form of photons. These are atomic emissions. The analysis is performed by studying these emissions. As discussed earlier, the different atoms will have different energy levels. Hence, the energy emitted by atoms will also be different for different atoms. The emissions will have different wavelengths. From these wavelength, the experimenter is able to identify the type of atoms. Similarly, the intensity of the emissions is dependent on the concentration or the quantity of the atoms present in the sample. If more the number of atoms, more is the intensity, and vice versa. In this manner, one can identify a particular atom present in the sample as well as its concentration. Hit that like button and share the video with your friends if you have enjoyed it. Until next time, stay calm and keep learning. Peace out.